Aamir is celebrating his 45th birthday on 14th March. Heartiest congratulations from the entire team at Bollywood Hungama.
Thank you. So sweet. Thank you so much.
Hi, this is Aamir Khan and you're watching BollywoodHungama.com.
Zubaani daave to bahut log karte rahte hain. Zubaani daave to bahut log karte rahte hain. Junoon ke kaam ko karke dikhaana hota hai. We have with us a unique phenomenon in the Indian film industry who has been setting new yardsticks and benchmarks of excellence. Aamir Khan, pleasure having you back on Bollywood Hungama, first of all. You also happen to be the youngest Padma Bhushan Awardee in India. That must be a great high.
Is that so? I'm not aware of that. Is that
I
so?
I think so.
It's really a great honor for me. I feel really humbled and I feel so nice that, you know, this kind of a honor is being bestowed upon me by my country. It's really something that I feel so humbled and happy with. It's quite amazing.
You got Padma Shri, I think, almost like, say, 9 years back in that.
Yeah, about 7 years ago, I think.
I think 8 years back.
Okay, maybe.
2002 or something.
Yeah, that's right. 2002. Yeah. Correct.
Your film said that excellence ko follow karo and success apne aap se milegi. And you are kind of a jeeta jata example of that.
Well, you know, in any case, I feel that success is never in our hands. It's not in our control also often. So I think that what we can do best is do work that we enjoy doing. Okay. That is what I believed. For me, making a film is not just the end result. It's also the process of making the film. You know, you spend 1 year, sometimes 2 years in the journey of making a film. So for me, the journey is very important. The process is very important. And it should be something that gives us joy and satisfaction. I believe in doing things that I enjoy doing. I believe in trying to do it as well as I can. That's what I concentrate on. And that's what gives me a high.
Definitely. And the kind of success that Three Idiots has seen, I think that is unprecedented. Madhavan, I was speaking to the other day, and he was saying that even EFG centers as well, it has done as well as A centers and overseas and all. It's still running in theaters.
Yeah, it's remarkable. I mean, in the last 20 years, I haven't seen this kind of a success in any film, you know, that I have, as an audience, been also part of. It's a rare kind of a success that a film gets. It's also, I mean, the kind of universal appeal it's had, whether it's, like you said, a small village or a small town in India to anywhere in the world, it's been received pretty much similarly across the globe. And that's remarkable to see because, you know, more and more you find films that are being made are for a particular kind of audience and not for a universal audience. So this has a very universal appeal. Actually, more importantly, I think it has had a very positive impact on audiences. That's what excites me. What really excites me is when I'm part of a film which not only is a success, but actually more than that, it has a very strong impact on the audience. Kind of sometimes changes the way you think or feel, like Tare Zameen Par or Three Idiots, films which are very inspirational, you know, Rang De Basanti or Lagan, Sarfarosh. These films really give me a lot of satisfaction, apart from the success factor, apart from the obvious success factor.
Recently, we had the release of My Name is Khan, I think a very nice film. But almost immediately after the release of the film, lots of SMSs started doing the rounds and lots of things started being written on Twitter and other websites that 35 years it took for Three Idiots to break the record of Sholay, and now it took 6 weeks for My Name is Khan to break the record of Three Idiots. The reality is totally something else. Does it kind of bother you, upset you that you've never spoken about box office? I think I've attended many of your functions and all. You always talk about your film. You've never kind of really spoken about box office success of any of your films per se. Does it upset you that these kind of things happen, Hassan?
No, it doesn't upset me because I think that I genuinely believe that no matter what you do, if a film doesn't work, you cannot fool the people. You can do whatever you want. And when a film works, you don't have to convince anybody. You can never stop a great film and you can never make a film that doesn't work. You cannot make it work. You can do what you want. You can buy editorial, you can print ads, you can do what you want. So that's what I believe. That's what I've always believed. And I think it's silly. I'm not commenting about this particular film. I just want to clarify. I think that conceptually it's a silly thing to try and do. I think in any case, I mean, you know, you are a person from the media. You would know how a film is doing in any case.
Definitely.
So there's little you can do. And I think that, you know, I don't want to comment about others, but what I can say about myself is that when I do a film, I want to know. I want to know very, very honestly how the audience has reacted to my film. You know, so I want to actually understand firsthand how my film has been received. So I make it a point to go to the theaters and watch my film with the audience.
You've been doing it for a long time, in fact.
For a long time, from my first film, actually. That's how I've been all along. And I think the numbers are indicative, or that's one yardstick of judging success. But that's not the only yardstick.
You've never been in a hurry that maybe other stars, they would have kind of gone ahead and signed like 3-4 films. Your fans would definitely want you to kind of sign more films, but you're not signing any new films and all.
Yeah, I know. That's a big
lot of talk about your film with Anurag Kashyap. I spoke to Anurag the other day, and he said that till the time the script is not locked, Aamir doesn't kind of say yes to anything.
That's correct. And my fans are a little upset with me that I am not acting right now. But I think at this point of time, first of all, I need to be with my family. When you go through a personal loss, it suddenly makes you realize how fragile life is, you know. Something that I want to stop and take stock of. But in any case, I had planned that, you know, my plate is full. I have responsibilities as a producer as well. I've taken on 3 films that I've produced. So this is a great time to concentrate on these 3 films, you know, starting with PP Live. What I'd like to say to my fans, you know, is that PP Live is as much my film as Three Idiots is. Because it's a film that I believe in. It's a film that I am part of. I may not be part of it as an actor, but I'm part of it as a producer. So it's something I creatively believe in. I think that the film's turned out well. I'm really happy with the way the film's turned out. So
lots of stuff we've been hearing, like, say, in media itself about the film. Sure. The way it's been doing at Sundance and even Berlin and all. That's the way it's been received.
It's been well received. But importantly, what I'm trying to say is that while I may not be acting right now, but my audience will get to see my work. PP Live is my film. As much as Three Idiots is, so is Delhi Belly, and in so is Dhobi Ghat. And Dhobi Ghat, of course, I'm also acting.
You're acting in that as well. So at least there's something to look forward to.
No, I assure you that PP Live also will not disappoint you. Or, you know, my other films.
But Aamir Khan, the actor, is something else. It, like I said, lots of people have said that he's like an Eid ka chand who comes once in a year.
Well, I still come once in a year. You'll get to see me in Dhobi Ghat. But importantly, you know, I do feel that I also need to really, you know, give time to my personal life. And I just need to, like, take a pause for a bit.
Last year, I think one of the biggest contributions that you made to the film industry was the way you just spearheaded the entire movement for the multiplexes and the producers. The way you kind of took initiative in that.
I don't think I really spearheaded it. I think it was something that happened organically. I think the producers over the, you know,
but your,
2 years
the way ago. You kind of lent the presence, and even Shah Rukh Khan, the way both of you guys lent the presence, and I think that definitely added a lot of weight to the entire thing, and amicable solution was reached.
I think that it was something that each and every individual producer was feeling for a very long time, and so what we saw as a culmination was actually, you know, everyone feeling a certain way and wanting to address that issue. Yeah. And that's what happened. I don't think I could ever take credit for spearheading that.